Now to take those short rows and make a spiral effect to the triangles. First of all, this is a little sample I already did up. I'm going to omit this first triangle here, because even though this one was easy to do because I increased to make it, the last one I have to decrease. That's just a little bit too much work, and I would rather just make it as easy as possible. So if you just concentrate on this line here, so now this fabric's going to have a point starting here and creating that upside down triangle, and then we're going to do the opposite side. You want to start out with an odd number of stitches. I have 19 here. You could do whatever you want. It's really your choice. Now the easy way with having the eyelets is you just bring every needle except for one out to hold. You have your carriage set to hold, and then you knit two rows. Bring the next needle from holding position to forward working position, knit two rows. And eventually I could take off my three prong claw weight, or three teeth, and put on the normal claw weight and just continue in this manner all the way. And when I push the last needle in, I will end with the carriage over on the right. So here I have my last needle. I'm pushing to forward working position, and I knit to the right. Now I'm going to reverse that and go in the opposite direction. But now to show you how to do the automatic wrap when working this spiral triangles. And if you notice that as you're knitting along, the stitches start popping up, that's a sign to tell you to put more weight on is all. So with the automatic wrap, I knit one row across, I push the last needle knitted to holding position, knit back, push two needles to forward working position, knit across, push the last one knitted to holding position. And I keep doing that again till my carriage is going to be over here on the right when I have the last needle knitted. Then I'm just going to keep going back and forth, back and forth. And you work this until you want your fabric a certain length. And then you, well, you get all your stitches back into working position. And you just bind off is all. So here I am at the end of the second triangle. Here's the first one. Now the eyelets on the first row were put close to the cast on edge. If I had continued doing the easy, not wrapping the needle, then I would have had a set of eyelets along here. So now I bring all needles except for the one or two, depending whether you're wrapping or you're not wrapping, and just continue, as I mentioned, for as long as you want this to be. Once you get all needles back into working position, then just do a bind off. Well, I hope you get to use this technique, and I'm going to show one other thing that you could do with this spiral triangle. So now a little twist in this swirl triangles. Just to make it go faster, I'm going to have the eyelets. So again, I have my carriage here on the left. I cast it on 20 stitches this time. It doesn't matter if you have odd or even stitches on this. What you do want to make sure is, however wide you want this to be, you only want to use half the stitches, because now this is going to make a circle, and it would make a nice washcloth, dishcloth, or if you made it larger, can be a pillow cover. So I have my one needle to hold in position, knit two rows, push the next one back, knit two rows, push the next one back. And I do this all the way down. And I notice the stitches seem to be popping off, so I need to put another weight over there and possibly one over here, or just hold the material below the work, below the bed. Now this time, instead of knitting one row across, I'm going to knit the two rows and keep the carriage on the left here. Then I continue by pulling the needles back out to hold in position and doing my short rows. And I'm going to keep doing that. And what I do is I take the weight off so that it's not really weighted. And I'm going to keep going until this cast on row lines up with the last row. Now, I probably shouldn't have done the lace on the beginning there, probably even had waste yarn, a row of ravel cord, so I had the live stitches and I could graft that last row. But I think you could see how this is going to end up.